I call that my 40% rule, where like a car has a governor on it. It can go 130, you know, the governor's only going 91. And the whole thing about that is a true statement, like what you said. Our mind wants to protect us. The mind is like, honestly, it has a tactical advantage over us. It knows our deepest, darkest fears or insecurities. It knows where we start to feel, we start getting that doubt creeping that says, hey man, you know what, man, maybe this isn't good. Let's go back home to the wife. Let's go back home to the kids. This is not comfortable. So in that moment, the mind directs us. It's a protective mechanism. It saves us from doing bodily harm, or it really saves us from discovering that the mind's like, I want to be in charge of you. I don't want you to be in charge of me. So it tells you, let's just stop right here. But once you start breaking through that barrier and start breaking down that governor that you've put in your mind, because we forget we are in control of our mind. We believe it's the other way around. No, we put in our minds what we should do, but we believe our mind is telling us, it's giving us all this feedback. We have to reprogram it. It tells, no, we're good. We're good, we got this. This sucks, but it's okay. The reason why we go back to what happens is because our goals are too lofty. We're not achieving our goals fast enough. So what happens is, you know what, oh man, we're very impatient nowadays. For me.
At L'Oreal Group, 100% of our natural ingredients will be sustainably sourced by 2030. This is how we create the beauty that moves the world.
It was good. I didn't have a phone. I was out of this world by myself. It was a race against David Goggins. It wasn't a race against, God, I don't look good for this person or that person. It was me. I got to change myself. So for me, if I lost 5 pounds in a week, I got a feeling. I allowed myself to feel proud of that. I didn't look at it. I got to lose 106 pounds. I'm like, man, I went from 297, now I'm 292. In 1 week, man, I'm killing it. We're not proud of ourselves for the small accomplishments. What we need is we need this monstrosity of the thing to happen and say, ah, I did it. Nah. There's a process that you have to go through, and patience is the process. And if you don't have patience, after a week, I haven't lost 30 pounds and I'm done. I'm over it. So that's why I found out with people, man, they're not patient enough to realize and to enjoy the moment, not live in it. Just enjoy it. There's no finish line in life. But enjoy that moment. Roger that, man. I lost 5. Let me go 10 next week. So that's the whole thing about it. That's how people lose it. It's an endless process. Endless process. All that crap that I went through in my life to get here today, it is tattooed. It is tattooed in my brain. Every day I wake up, I'm constantly battling that person that is like, man, you know, back in the day, this happened to you, man. You know, like, you couldn't read, it's Daggone Junior. All these things start to creep up, even now where you're at today.
You'll never know, you'll never know. If you believe you can. Thicket.
New Thicket, Stick It, Thicket.